everybody, Tom Barnes, Chicago scene downtown. The holidays are in full bloom, and take a look at this. Just beyond those windows is the Chicago Children's Choir. They're getting ready for their big holiday performance they have coming up this Saturday at the Epiphany Center of the Performing Arts. And I'm talking to DeAndre, who's been part of the Chicago Children's Choir since third grade. So I'm gonna get the scoop on what that's like and what you can expect for the concert this weekend for the Chicago scene. All right, it's not bad digs for a rehearsal space with the Chicago Children's Choir. I'm here with DeAndre. How are you, DeAndre?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. So you are a baritone in the choir, right?
Mm-hmm. I am a baritone in my 10th year at the Chicago Children's Choir.
10 years. So how did you end up getting into it? And tell me what it's like from your perspective to be in it and be able to play for the city of Chicago.
Yeah, I actually started with the Chicago Children's Choir when I was in third grade in our in-school program at a school called Ann Pritzker. It's in Wicker Park on Chicago's northwest side.
Sure.
And I sang in that ensemble for about 5 years until I transitioned to the Dimension Ensemble, and that's our choir for boys with changing voices. And after a year in that ensemble, I transitioned to Voice of Chicago, which I'm in my fourth and final year of now. And it honestly feels amazing to be singing in such a talented, diverse group. I feel like we've worked really, really hard on our Songs of the Seasons program, and to sing all of these different music types of music from all different parts of the world is an incredible experience that you don't get to have very often. And to do it for the city of Chicago, representing the youth of Chicago, is also a great experience.
Yeah, I gotta imagine you've made some friends in your years in the choir. Just, you know, I mean, you've been it for a few years, and you said this is your fourth and final year in the what particular choir?
The Voice of Chicago.
That's just kind of, you're graduating out of it kind of thing, right?
Yeah, it's our top performing ensemble that does a lot more performances and touring.
So the big show is this weekend at the Epiphany Center of the Arts. And it's at 5:30, and what can people expect for that particular performance?
You can definitely expect a lot of classical music. You can expect some choreography, some dancing, some world music. I'm pretty sure we're singing in 7 or 9 different languages, so you know, make sure your program is ready for the translations and things like that. And you can expect to see a lot of young people, a lot of passion, a lot of great music. Probably some snacks, some love, some family, friends, and just a lot of Christmas and holiday joy.
So I know that there's a couple of numbers that have a little bit of movement going on and a little action going on. Can you give me like what people can expect in terms of that? Because it's not just, not that standing and singing isn't hard enough to do, but there's a little bit more than people might expect.
Yeah. In choir, we do a lot of movement and especially a lot of dancing. Mm-hmm. For our number Silver and Gold, we have an entire stage performance with props, and we interact with the audience. We're in the aisles a lot, and we dance and sing all at the same time at a very high level of excellence. So don't just expect us to stand and sing and not really interact with the audience, but we also do a lot of dancing and interacting as well.
You mentioned the different languages. Is it tough to sing in different languages, or is it kind of you just memorize the parts that you need and then move on, or you kind of study a little bit about what exactly is that you're singing and how you're singing it?
I think you definitely have to study what it is that you're singing and how you sing it, because otherwise it'd be pretty hard to interpret emotionally you know, the subject is. And so you may not know how to speak the language, but you should definitely know what you're singing and how you should be singing it.
So people that head to the show, how much time should they block out? How long does a performance last? And is there an intermission? How about any of that stuff?
Our performances are usually anywhere from 30 minutes to an hour to 2 hours. I'm pretty sure there's an intermission in this one, and it's broken into two parts, so.
Fantastic. It's a beautiful venue that you guys are playing at, and you have a beautiful venue here. I'm just showing folks a little behind the scenes because you guys are doing one of your final rehearsals here at the Pritzker Pavilion, which has to do with the school you went to. So it's all like full circle for you in this particular moment, right?
Definitely. It's a great moment for my senior year. Definitely, yeah. A full circle moment.
What school do you go to?
I go to Jones College Prep.
And do you know where you're heading out after that?
I'm applying to NYU, University of Chicago, Berkeley. Haven't quite decided on where I'm going yet, and also I'm finishing up applications.
Awesome. Well, I wish you the best. And for people who want tickets and they're seeing this, what's the best way they should go about? Is there a website they should know about?
Yeah, we have our website, ccchoir.org, and you can find all of our events on the calendar page on the website. And you could also head to the Chicago Children's Choir Instagram or Facebook page, or Twitter, I believe, and our website should be there.
You guys are all over.
Yeah.
Well, fantastic. Thank you very much for taking time to chat with me. I know you got rehearsals starting in about a few minutes, so I'll let you get back to what you're doing.
All right. Thank you so much.
No problem. Truly is a holiday is when the Chicago Children's Choir gets ready for their big annual holiday performance, TBARNAS at WGNTV.com. If you have a suggestion for the Chicago scene, that's T Barnes at WGNTV.com. Thank you for watching, everybody. Happy holidays.